Now we will discuss some applications on this concept. So now we will solve some problems. Here the first problem is 2 sin a by 2 is equal to root of 1 plus sin a minus root of 1 minus sin a. Okay, this is given one. So we know the formula for 2 sin a by 2. What is the formula for 2 sin a by 2? 2 sin a by 2 is equal to plus or minus square root of 1 plus sin a minus or plus or minus square root of 1 minus sin a. This is the actual formula. But we have given that 2 sin a by 2 is equal to root of 1 plus sin a minus root of 1 minus sin a. Now the both the left hand sides are equal, LHS are equal. Now compare the right hand sides. Now first term, compare the first term. Here the first term is root of 1 plus sin a, but here plus r means root of 1 plus sin a. Already we discussed root x square is equal to x when x is positive and it is equal to minus x when x is negative. Okay, now here root, here plus r means root of 1 plus sin a is there, here root of 1 plus sin a is there. That means it is treated as positive. It is nothing but c plus a, c plus s, sorry. It is nothing but c plus s. That means cos a by 2 plus sin a by 2. Here, by comparing these two, we can say that this root of 1 plus sin a is treated as positive. That means cos a by 2 plus sin a by 2 is positive. That means c plus s is greater than 0. By comparing these two, we can write c plus s greater than 0. Now observe the second term. Here minus of root of 1 minus sin a is there. Here minus of plus r is root of 1 minus sin a. That means, so minus minus both are same. So in place of plus r minus root of 1 minus sin a, there is only root of 1 plus 1 minus sin a. That means here plus r means root of 1 minus sin a. That means root of 1 minus sin a is treated as positive value. That means c minus s also positive. Understand? Once again, 2 sin a by 2 equal root of 1 plus sin a minus root of 1 minus sin a. But the actual formula is 2 sin a by 2 equal plus r minus this minus of plus r minus this. Now the LHS are equal. Now compare the right hand part. So here, in place of plus r minus root of 1 plus sin a, there is only root of 1 plus sin a. That means here he is taking only positive. It is possible only when the root value is positive, in the c plus s value is positive. So it is possible only when c plus s is greater than 0. Similarly, observe that minus of root 1 minus sin a minus of plus r minus root of 1 minus sin a. Here also the minus minus same. Here plus, in place of plus r minus root of 1 minus sin a, just is taking positive value. That means it is also treated as positive. In case of the c minus s is also positive. Already we discussed about this graph, about the ranges of a by 2. Here already we discussed. Yet in this area, here in this area, c plus s and c minus s both are positive. C plus s greater than 0 and c minus s greater than 0. So in this area, c plus s positive, c minus s negative. Here c plus s negative, c minus s positive. Here both are negative. Already we discussed in the just now. Here we have only c plus s and c minus s both are positive. Then with the help of these two conditions, we have to find out the range of a by 2. So it is possible only within the region. So here the region is minus pi by 4 to plus pi by 4. If a by 2 lies between minus pi by 4 to plus pi by 4, 2 sin a by 2 equal to this one. So from this we can write a by 2 belongs to minus pi by 4 to plus pi by 4. Otherwise in general also 2n pi minus pi by 4 to 2n pi plus pi by 4. Here we can write 2n pi minus pi by 4 comma 2n pi plus pi by 4. This is the way how to find the range of a by 2. If suppose we have given like this. So one more example. If suppose 2 cos a by 2 is equal to root of 1 minus sin a minus root of 1 plus sin a. Now what is the range of a by 2? Here also you have to find out the range of a by 2. So what is the formula for 2 cos a by 2? Actual formula is 2 cos a by 2 is equal to root of plus or minus root of 1 plus sin a plus or minus root of 1 minus sin a. This is the actual formula. But we have given 2 cos a by 2 equal to this one. Now compare LHS. So both are equal. Now compare right hand side. Here a plus or minus root of 1 plus sin a is there. But here minus root of 1 plus sin a. So it is treated as negative. So from these two we can write c plus s is negative. Understand? Here in place of plus or minus root of 1 plus a, just he is writing minus root of 1 plus sin a. That means in place of plus or minus he is taking minus. So that means c plus s is negative. So let's observe the second term. Plus or minus root 1 minus sin a is there. Plus simply here there is only plus root 1 minus sin a. So in case of this it is treated as positive. That means c minus s is positive. Okay, so from this we get c plus s less than 0 and c minus s greater than 0. So now with the help of this, by observing this graph, we can find out the range of a by 2. C plus s negative, c minus s positive. Here c plus s positive, c minus s negative. C plus s negative means in this area, here in this interval, c plus negative, c plus s and c minus s positive. In this interval is nothing but 5 pi by 4 to 7 pi by 4. If a by 2 lies between 5 pi by 4 to 7 pi by 4, in this interval c plus s negative, c minus s positive. That means here the range of a by 2 is, this implies the range of a by 2. So a by 2 belongs to 5 pi by 4 to 7 pi by 4. 5 pi by 4 to 7 pi by 4. Here also we can write 2n pi plus 5 pi by 4 comma 2n pi plus 7 pi by 4. Or 2n pi plus 5 pi by 4 comma 2n pi plus 7 pi by 4. This is the way how to find the range of a by 2 when the 2 sin a by 2 or 2 cos a by 2 is given. In case of this expression, 2 sin a by 2 equals something. Here with respect to this formula, you can find out the range of a by 2. Here also we have given 2 cos a by 2 equals something. The actual formula is 2 cos a by 2. By comparing these two, we can find out the nature of c plus s and c minus s. With the help of this nature, c plus s, c minus s, we can find out the range of a by 2. Understand? So this is the one of the method, one of the application. So two methods are there remaining. So now observe this problem. Here, if 450 less than a less than 630, then find the value of cos a by 2. Now first of all write the formula of 2 cos a by 2 formula. We have a formula for cos a by 2. What is that? 2 cos a by 2 equal to 2 cos a by 2 is equal to plus or minus root of 1 plus sin a and plus or minus root of 1 minus sin a. See, this is the actual formula. Here we have to find out the exact value of cos a by 2. Okay. So how can you decide the symbol in front of root of 1 plus sin a and root of 1 minus sin a? Here we have given that 450 less than a less than 630. We have to find out the range of a by 2. With the help of range of a 2, we can deal with the symbols for this. So now dividing both sides by 2. Then what will happen? Just dividing both sides by 2. So here is nothing but 225 degrees less than a by 2 is less than 315 degrees. What is the position of this angle a by 2? If you know the position of the angle in this diagram, so we can give the symbol. Here 225 to 315, it is in the interval 225 to 315, it lies in this interval. Okay, so here this lies between 5π/4 to 7π/4. In this area, C plus S is negative and C minus S is positive. Here A by 2 lies between 225 to 315, means A by 2 lies within the interval. Here we know that the nature of C plus S and C minus S. Here C plus S is negative and C minus S is positive. Okay. So here we have a clear idea. With respect to this diagram, we can give the symbol. Where is C plus S? Here A by 2 is the lies in this region. In this region, we know that C plus S is negative and C minus S positive. So now come to the problem. Here A by 2 lies between 5π/4 to 7π/4. In this region, C plus S is negative and C minus S is positive. So here we know that C plus S is nothing but plus or minus root of 1 plus sin A. Here C plus S is negative, that means we should take only negative value, minus of root of 1 plus sin A. Should write plus or in place of plus or minus root of 1 plus sin A, minus root of 1 plus sin A. And another one, C minus S is greater than 0. That means, so we know that C minus S is equal to plus or minus root of 1 minus sin A. Here in the region, in this region, this C minus S is positive. We should write only positive value, that is root of 1 minus sin A. Okay, so just replace this value by these two. Then we will get the formula 2 cos A by 2. This is the way how to find the function value with respect to the given range. In previous slide, we discussed how to find the range when the function is given. Here the range is given with respect to range, we can write the function. So now 2 cos A by 2 is equal to 2 cos A by 2 is equal to, write down the value of this, is equal to minus root of 1 minus sin A. And in place of C minus S, just write this one. So you should write positive. So 1 minus sin A. This is the formula for cos A by 2. If you want to find cos A by 2, just send 2 to this right side. So here you can write cos A by 2 is equal to 1 by 2 into something. Okay. This is the way how to find the function when the range of the angle is given. So next, observe the third problem. Here the value of 4 sin 27, it means we have to find out sin A by 2. Here you have given that sin 27, we can write that is equal to 4 sin 27 means 54 by 2. Just we have to find out sin A by 2, simply, just like sin A by 2. What is the region? 27 degrees, A by 2 lies between, A by 2 lies between this part. Here A by 2 lies between minus pi by 4 to pi by 4, because it is a 27 degrees. So it should be in the first quadrant. So less than 45. So sine of 27 degrees. That means 27 belongs to this interval. In this interval already we know C plus S and C minus S both are positive. Here both are positive, here both are negative. Here C plus S positive, C minus S negative, and here C plus S negative, C minus S positive. Okay, right? Is there any doubt? Right. Sine 27, that means sine 54 by 2. It is in the form of sine A by 2. If you have a formula, okay, right. So now here we have a clear idea. 27 degrees lies in this region. In this region C plus S and C minus S positive. Both are positive. Here we have to find out sine 27 degrees. Now with respect to this condition, find out sine A by 2 formula and just replace A by 2 by 27 degrees. That's it. Otherwise replace A by 54. So now first of all write down the formula. What is the formula? So simply 2 sine A by 2. 2 sine A by 2. 2 sine A by 2. Actual formula for 2 sine A by 2 is plus or minus. 2 sine A by 2 equal plus or minus. 1 minute. Here we have to find out 4 sine 54 by 2. It is in the form of 4 sine A by 2. First of all, find out the value of sine A by 2. What is the formula for 2 sine A by 2? 2 sine A by 2. 2 sine A by 2 is equal to plus or minus root of 1 plus sine A minus of plus or minus root of 1 minus sine A. This is the actual formula. With the help of this region, this nature of the C plus S, C minus, you have to find the exact value. Then after that, by replacing A by 54 degrees, we can find out sine 54 by 2. That means sine 27. So now, here C plus S greater than 0, C minus S greater than 0. Just simply write down positive value and positive value. And replace 27 degrees by A by 2, otherwise replace A by 54. Then we will write 2 sine 54 by 2, just replace A by 54 is equal to, so plus or minus is there here, but C plus S, C minus are positive, you should write only positive value. So root of 1 plus sine 54 degrees minus root of 1 minus sine 54 degrees. Now we have the value of sine 54. What is the value of sine 54? Sine 54. If you have a clear idea about sine 54, so you can write 2 sine 4 sine 27 degrees. Just simply write down sine 54 value, otherwise cos 36 value. What is cos 36 or sine 54? Both are same. So sine 54 degrees is equal to root 5 plus 1 by 4. Just simply substitute sine 54 value, root 5 plus 1 by 4. From this, you can write 2 sine 27 degrees is equal to root of 1 plus root 5 plus 1 by 4 minus root of 1 minus root 5 plus 1 by 4. Now simplify this root values. So here we will get 2 sine 27 degrees is equal to root of, So 4 plus root 5 plus 1, 5 plus root 5, 5 plus root 5 by 4 minus root of 4 minus 4 minus root 5 minus 1, 3 minus root 5 by 4. Here we can write root of 5 plus root 5 by whole by 2 minus root of 3 minus root 5 whole by 2. So from that we will get 2 sine 27 degrees is equal to root 5 plus root 5 by 2 minus root 3 minus root 5 by 2. Now from this we can write 4 sine 27 degrees is equal to 5 plus root 5 minus root of 3 minus root 5. This is the way how to find the value of sine 27, sine 9, cos 81, sine 81, sine 9, like that. This is the way how to find the value of sine of a by 2 form if a is known angle. Here in place of a by 2 there is 27 degrees. We can write 54 by 2. 54 degrees is known value for sine functions and cos functions. In the previous sessions we discussed how to find sine 54 and cos 36, sine 18 and like that. Okay, this is the way how to find the value of 4 sine 27 degrees. Okay, next see. So observe this problem. Here, if alpha, beta, gamma, delta are the smallest positive angle in ascending order, smallest positive angle in the ascending order of their magnitudes, and whose their sines equal to kk is positive, what is it meaning? If suppose sin theta is equal to 1 by 2, you want to find different angles for theta. These are also in the increasing order of magnitude. So sin theta equal to 1 by 2 means theta equal to 30. So next angle is 150 degrees. Sin 150 also 1 by 2. Next angle, again we have to enter into the first quadrant like that. Because sin is positive in first and second quadrant. So sin theta is equal to 1 by 2 is fixed. We have to find out different values of theta in increasing order of magnitudes. Sin 30, 1 by 2, sin 50, 150, 1 by 2, like that. So here we have given that alpha, beta, gamma, delta are the smallest positive angles. Okay, smallest positive angles in the angles in ascending order of magnitude. Okay, and which have the same equal to value equal to k, where k is positive. Okay, so here we have to find out the value of 4 sine alpha by 2, 4 sine beta by 2, sine gamma by 2 plus sine delta by 2. Here let us consider the first angle be alpha. Next, just we have given that second angle is beta and third angle is gamma and fourth angle is delta. But we have given that sine of these angles is equal to k. So let us consider sine alpha is equal to k. We have to express this value 4 sine alpha by 2, sine beta by 2, sine gamma by 2, sine delta by 2 in terms of k. If we have sine alpha, then we can write k like that. So what about the beta, gamma, delta? These angles should be in increasing order in magnitudes and sine should be equal to k. So first angle is alpha, sine alpha equal to k. So here we can write beta is equal to pi minus alpha, because if alpha is first quadrant, sine alpha equal to k. So sine pi minus alpha is also equal to sine alpha k, because in second quadrant sine is positive. That's why beta is equal to pi minus alpha. So here also sine pi minus alpha gives same value, that equal to sine alpha equal to k. This is the way we have to find out all the angles. So this beta value also pi minus alpha now. Now what about the gamma? Next one, these angles should be in increasing of magnitudes. So in first and second quadrant sine is positive. Again you want to find one more angle. So you have to enter into the again first quadrant. So just observe that if suppose here is the value alpha sin alpha equal k. Here pi minus alpha is there. Here also you will get sin alpha, same value. If you want to find one more angle, which sine of the angle equal to k, again you have to enter into the first quadrant. So how can you write after one rotation first quadrant angle? 2 pi plus alpha. So consider gamma b 2 pi plus alpha. Next, if you want to find the value of this one also, again you have to enter into the second quadrant. Now in here second quadrant angle is 3 pi minus alpha. This is the way how to write the angles beta, gamma, delta. Clearly, alpha, pi minus alpha, 2 pi plus alpha, 3 pi minus, these are in ascending order of their magnitudes. And if you apply sine for this, it will give same answer. Sine pi minus alpha, sine alpha. Sine 2 pi plus alpha, sine alpha. Sine 3 pi minus alpha, sine alpha. Now substitute in this expression. 4 into, now the expression is 4 into, just replace beta, gamma, delta by all these values, pi minus alpha, 2 pi plus alpha, 3 pi minus alpha. Then we will get the every term in terms of alpha. Okay, 4 sine alpha by 2 plus 4 sine beta by 2. Beta by 2 means pi minus alpha by 2. Pi by 2 minus alpha by 2 plus sine gamma by 2. That means sine of gamma by 2. 2 pi plus alpha by 2. And another one is sine delta by 2. That means sine of delta by 2 means 3 pi by 2 minus alpha by 2. This is the way we can change the angles into in terms of alpha. Now simplify this. 4 sine alpha by 2. Sine 90 minus theta cos theta. 4 into cos of alpha by 2. Okay, next. Sine pi plus theta. Sine pi plus theta. Pi plus theta is the angle in the third quadrant. In third quadrant sine is negative. So minus. But pi is there. There is no change in the function. Sine alpha by 2. Next one. Come to this one. Sine 3 pi by 2 minus alpha by 2. 3 pi by 2 minus theta belongs to third quadrant. In third quadrant sine is negative. And multiple of 90 is odd. So there will be change like cos. So minus cos alpha by 2. Now simplify this. 4 sine alpha by 2 minus sine alpha by 2. 3 sine alpha by 2. Next 4 cos alpha by 2 minus cos alpha by 2. 3 cos alpha by 2. Now here we can write 3 into cos alpha by 2 plus sin alpha by 2. We have to express this value in terms of k, but we have given that sin alpha is equal to k. If sin alpha is there, then only we can replace k. We can express in terms of k. We have to express this in terms of sin alpha. Already you know this is nothing but C plus S. You know that C plus S is equal to plus or minus root of 1 plus sin A. Here also, here alpha is the angle in the first quadrant. So alpha by 2 should be in the first interval. C plus S, C minus, both are positive. Here C plus is positive. Here we can write this is nothing but root of 1 plus sin alpha. Cos alpha by 2 plus sin alpha equal, otherwise you can write it is equal to root of something whole square. This is nothing but root of whole square. Here cos alpha is in the angle in the first quadrant. Alpha by 2 should be in the interval minus pi by 4 to pi by 4. Okay, so in this interval we know that this is positive. So C plus is positive. Here we can write root of 1 plus sin alpha directly. We know that sin alpha is equal to k. So now the value of this is equal to 3 into root of 1 plus k. So whatever it may be, the multiple of sin alpha by 2, cos alpha by 2, sin beta by 2, like that. So that is not the matter. Here this is the important way how to write alpha, beta, gamma, delta in terms of same angle alpha. See here, first angle is alpha, second angle pi minus alpha, 2 pi plus alpha, 3 pi minus alpha. These are the angles we have given, alpha, beta, gamma, delta. Just names are different. The magnitude should be an increasing order, but sine value of sine of this angle should be always same, that is equal to k. This is the problem. Okay, so your alpha equal to first angle. So beta equal to pi minus alpha, gamma equal to 2 pi plus alpha, delta equal to 3 pi minus alpha. Just simply replace beta, gamma, delta by these three angles, then we will get this type of expression. Here this is nothing but C plus S. We know that C plus S equal to plus or minus root of 1 plus n. But here we have clear idea, alpha is the angle in the first quadrant. Alpha by 2 should be lies in the first interval, minus pi by 4 to pi by 4. In that interval C plus S is positive. So simply we can write plus of something root 1 plus sin alpha, and sin alpha is equal to k. This is the very, very important problem. So next come to this one. This is also simplest one. Already we discussed this type of problem in case of cos function. Just to we find out sin 57. Here we have given sin 81 degrees. See here we can write sin 81 is equal to cos 9 also. It is better to write in terms of cos. Here we have to find cos 9 degrees value. Cos 9 degree value. We don't know cos 9 degrees value, but we have idea about cos 18, sin 18. Try to express cos 9 in terms of 18. That means we have to write cos A by 2 formula in terms of A. So what is the formula for cos A by 2? So we know that 2 cos A by 2 is equal to plus or minus square root of 1 plus sin A plus or minus square root of 1 minus sin A. This is the actual formula of cos A by 2. 2 cos A by 2 equals something. Here we have to find out cos 9 degrees value. Okay, 9 degrees. Where is 9 degrees? Just simply replace A by 18, then we will get this value. So before going that, we have to decide the symbol. Here 9 is equal to 18 by 2. It belongs to minus pi by 4 to pi by 4. In this region, C plus S and C minus S both are positive. Understand? See, this is the angle A. Let us consider this is angle A, 9 degrees. We can write that is equal to 18 degree by 2, A by 2 form. Here A by 2 belongs to this interval. In this interval, C plus S and C minus S both are positive. Okay, now with respect to this region, find out 2 cos A by 2 value and replace A by 18. Simply replace A by 18. Replace A by 18 degrees. Then we will get 2 cos 18 by 2 is equal to, so both are positive, you should write only positive, then root of 1 plus sin 18 plus, you should take only plus value because in this interval both are positive, should write only positive value, root of 1 minus sin 18 degrees. Now substitute sin 18 degrees value. What is sin 18 degrees value? Sin 18 degrees value is equal to root 5 minus 1 by 4. What is the value of sin 18? Root 5 minus 1 by 4. Just simply substitute sin 18 value. That is equal to 2 cos 9. 2 cos 9 degrees is nothing but 2 sin 81. 2 sin 81 or 2 cos 9. Both are equal. So now substitute the value. 1 plus sin 18 equal to root 5 minus 1 by 4. Okay, next, root 5 minus 1 by 4, just to simplify this, 4 plus root 5 minus 1 by 4 plus root of 4 minus root 5 plus 1 by 4. So now here the value in the root value is 4 minus 1, 3 plus root 5 whole by 2 plus 4 plus 1 root of 5 minus root 5 by 2. This is the value of 2 cos 9 degrees. What we have to find out? Just only sin 81, that means cos 9. Now this, from this, cos 9 degrees is equal to 1 by 4 into cos 9 degrees equal to 1 by 4 into root of 3 plus root 5 plus root of 5 minus root 5. This is the way how to find sin 81 or cos 9 degrees. Both are equal. Otherwise, you can write sin 81. Because cos 9 is nothing but sin 81. These two values are equal. This is the way how to find the trigonometric ratios of half angle. That means 18 by 2, 9 degrees, 81 degrees, 27 degrees, 54 degrees, like that. Okay. Right. Thank you.